So let's go with the part 2 of the video on linear probability models, probit and logit models. So the first library, that is R. In R we are going to use is foreign, and I just press it. We are uploading data from Woolridge Econometric Book, and the website address is given here, so I am going to read this data, read.dta. This is Stata data. I have explained it in my earlier videos, how to read data from Stata, SPSS, CSV, Excel file. So we are naming it AmRose. We are using library dplyr for manipulating data if and where required. Okay, and now I am converting it to data frame, and glimpse basically provides you an overview of the data. And you see here you have an overview of the data. If you look at this overview of the data, you have 753 observations and 22 rows. Most of the variables are measured in double, that is integers, continuous scale. So let's go back and run a regression model of what? That whether a female, married female, is in labor force or not is a function of, is regressed on husband income, education, experience, experience square to address nonlinearity, plus age, plus kids age less than 1, say less than 6, and kids aged 6 to 18, and data is as we have uploaded AmRose. So this is your linear model, and you can regress this line. Simple OLS formula, instead of getting usual OLS standard errors, we get heteroscedastic robust standard errors, and for that we have these heteroscedastic robust standard errors. You can check it out. And now we go with you see two extreme cases. We are picking two females. One is one having husband income $100,000 per annum, and the other one having $0. One female has education 5 years, that's minimum in our data, and the other has 17 years of education. One has 0 years of experience, the second has 30 years of experience. One is 20 years old and other is 52 years old, maximum age in our data. And one has two children, another has zero, and children above six both have no children. So this is your predicted variable, and we will predict linear probability model for these two females. So you see the probability for first female is -0.41 being in the labor force, and for female second female it will be in the labor force is 1.04. So less than 0 and greater than 1, that's one problem with linear probability model. But otherwise results make sense, that a female whose husband is not earning anything will have you see a very high probability of being in labor force, while the other has very low probability. So now, instead of living with linear probability model, I am applying here a logit model. And so this is your logit model, GLM. Now instead of using LM, we are using linear probability model. We are using generalized linear model, nonlinear model, and everything is same except that GLM and our link function, which I explained in my previous video, is logit model, and data is the same. So summary of this one is, you have all these coefficients as we have in OLS. OLS linear probability model, we'll see them shortly. We have here now a library effects. We are going to measure all effects here. So summary all dot effects and plot all dot effects. So you have here zoom it for better visibility, and now you have you see this is the impact of being in female, married female in labor force, having husband income ranging from $0 to $100,000. As income increases, female being in labor force, probability of being in labor force of a married woman decreases. Education, it increases. There is a non-linearity. There is non-linearity age effect. As age increases, probability of being married with woman in labor force decreases. Having kids decreases probability of being in labor force, and children aged 6 plus increases probability of being in the labor force. So you can see, you can regress it, its log likelihood function, McFadden R square, or what we call pseudo R square. Same is the case with probability model. You can have summary of probability model, you have some log likelihood function of McFadden library, LM test, LR probabilities. This is significant, overall it's significant. And now we test restricted model and unrestricted model. In this case, we are basically excluding experience and age. So this is your restricted model, and the upper one, the last one, profit regression was your unrestricted and likelihood ratio. You see, you have restricted and unrestricted, and we find that these restrictions don't hold, and as H naught is rejected. So here we are basically again predicting from three models against the predicted value among two females by using different models, and you see probabilities for logit and models are close to one for females who has husband's low income, high education, and other one has low probability, but these probabilities don't go out of 0 and 1. So we are using here, there are two ways to find out, to get these tables. This is a nice table. Instead of doing it manually, you can use these tables built in R. You can also get the same table with Stargazer. So again, you have more or less similar results. At the moment, I am going to describe simulated data to show that how linear probability model, probit models, and logit model look like. So I am setting seed 3-2-1. If you will set the same seed, you will get similar results as I have. Binomial random numbers 100 with probability 0.5, and x is equal to normal random numbers plus 2 times y. We'll regress y on x for linear regression model, for logit model, for probit model, and we'll generate a predicted variable xp. We'll have these responses, and now we'll plot. So when we plot x and y, it means simply these are your 0 and 1 probabilities. These are your 0 and 1 probabilities. We fit a linear probability model here. So this is your linear probability model. It may exceed 1, it may be less than 0, and now we fit a probit model. That's a green line, logit model, green line. So you see it's an S curve. Up to a certain point, linear probability model will be above this line, and after a certain threshold, logit model will show more probability of observing one than a linear probability model. And now we regress probit model. So you are unable, basically, if you look at this graph, it's very difficult to differentiate between blue and green lines. So these two are very close to each other. As I mentioned earlier, it's just a matter of taste. a choice what you like, whether you like Locket model or you like Probit model. As such, practically there is no difference. Thank you for watching. Take care.